We are going to be making the mesmerizing sunset that I made last time. I mean the animation. First, delete the default cube. You need to be in Eevee for this. Eevee. Let's do a plane. Press S 10. And it will become larger. And then go to edit mode. And then right click, subdivide. And then open this here. Increase the number of chords to 30. It will be like this. Select any one. Yeah. And change this to random. And this proportional editing to on and grab it and that if you scroll in it will decrease and if you scroll out you can also change the proportional size here. Yes, and do it again and again until you have something like this. If it's like this, control Z it. If it's less, it's okay. Yeah. This is here. And we don't even need to smooth it. Go to modifiers. Add A. Yeah. Where is it? Yeah. Wireframe modifier, it will look like this, but we need to get the original one first. Then here this will be press original, uncheck it, and you have the original one too. You can change the size. I want it like this. Even thickness. Let's see what that will do. Nothing. Yes, this is our thing now. Let's turn on images. Nothing happened. And then we have this. To make the color, go to materials tab, new, and then let's make this black, and then another new. Change this to MSN blue and this to 30 30 and if you go to render it will just look like this. To get it go to here, there will be material offset. Make it to 1 and it will be like this, but that is not glowing like that. To do that, go to render tab and then turn on bloom. It will get like this. You can go here to reduce the glowing effect. Just reduce the strength. I want it like this. Let's go to solid. And if we do duplicate this, shift D and then go Y and control. Yeah. Then see, it does it very well. See? That's why you need to Yeah, mirror it. Empty, add an empty. Grab it, G, Y, and then press Control. And then go here. Now it will be perfect here. If you scale it like this, then it won't be perfect here. Because I did it, 10, that is 10 meters. And this goes meter by meter. And if you hold Control, that's why you need to do a perfect amount of it. If you want to do 5, just do it. You can do 5. But don't do 5.5 like that. And then now add, apply this, add a, where is it? Mirror, yeah, mirror. Mirror object, select this empty, change it to Y. Now it looks perfect here. And we need to repeat this. Yeah. Now, if we duplicate this, first we need to apply this. And then, if we duplicate it and go to Y, Control. And this here will be perfect. Yeah, you can see a bit of the change, but you can see more. Then do Shift R, Control R, did they change it? Do Shift D, Y, Control, and make it like that. And do Shift R. Yeah, now it works. I just did another thing. Shift R, Shift R. No, not that many. Yeah, this will be perfect. And we need to set up a sun. Do Shift A and add a UV sphere. Scale it up. Very big. Grab it. Grab it here. Go to camera. Press 1. No. 2, 5, let's have the graphic. Do Control 3. Control 3. Control 1. Yeah. Zoom in a bit. Press 5. Do not go to orthographic view. Control R and number pad 0. Yeah. Now we need to move this up. Press G and then Z. I am moving that. This needs to be selected. G. Z. This will be okay. G. Y. We can go to the rendered view. Yeah, it looks fine. And we need to add the bling effect to this. Add the material. Make it a sun. Orange. Strength. If this cannot see it, just move this closer. why can not achieve? No, yep. Let's move this up a bit. Yeah, you can just equalize it. And then we need to move this back. G, Y, back, and then... I don't know why does it disappear, but go to camera, yes, laptop field, I do focus distance, let's make it 100, and now GY. I don't know why. Focal length. Camera. This could make it feel. GY. This could make this feel that it is really far. You can feel it's really far. The distance, it's really far. If you look it from a camera. To make the sun bigger, just scale it up. Not that. The sun setting. Let's select this camera. GY. Yes. GY. Back. I forgot to tell you one thing. Select the sun. Add a subdivision modifier. Render to 4:3. We put the 2. Yeah. Now it looks a bit more circle. Select the camera. GY. We could do one thing, select the sun, shift select the camera, do control P, yeah, object, and select. Not S, G, Y. Now it looks like sun is real at far. Yeah. Now this is over. And we need to animate this sun, this camera. We need to delete a bit. Delete. Tab. Okay. this only. The control select this. Z, Z, you can use lasso select. Yeah, let's use it. Control and then right click is lasso select. I selected it. Z, Shift Z, and then Control Shift. Control Shift, right click. Z, go to solid, control shift, right click. Yup. Now, delete. Now I will delete it. I just wasted my time, I think. That was rendered. And just, I made this. Shift A. Add a path. Where is my center point? Why is it here? Shift F. Yeah. My center point's there. Yeah, first. RZ90, go to tab, it points this way, then rotate, RZ180, enter tab, now it points this way, shift F. Just move it here. Move it down. It should be in the right center. Yes. S and then Y. The browser. It's large. Okay. Yep. This is okay. And now to animate it, select the camera. Shift select the line, do control P, follow path. And now if you play it, this goes with it, and the sound goes with it. And when does it end? When does the camera fully get there? It is... It is frame 101. Do the end 101. Over here. And you can see the preview. Oh man. It cannot. this. And delete this line first. Add another line. Radius to, let's make it 10. Enter. And then let us send Z, this to 0, Y 180, and no 90, no, and now let's do 90. Let's rotate more into which way it is pointing. Do tab RZ 9, minus 90. And let's see which way it is pointing. It's pointing that way, good. Select this. Now go to object tab and location, copy the X, control C, no Z, the Z, and then select the line, control V. Now it will be like this. Copy the Y, control C, select the line, control V. And then we can do additions with this. Plus, we need to do 10. Zero. Yeah, no. Let's zero. Yeah, this will be okay. Why does it happen? Put the Y to 0 again. And then select the camera, select this, control P, follow cut. Now let's see, it just moves. Yup, it's per not fit. Let's see if this loops. Yup, it looks perfect. Now we need to render. Select the location, to the render tab. It's here. And then go to the way we want it. Let's do loop. And now change this to FFmpeg. Change the container to MPEG-4, and then output quality to perpetually lossless. And here it is. You can just render animation by Control F12. Yep. It needs to render right now. It takes 5 seconds to 1 frame without any GPUs or anything. And thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe. Bye!